The Little Tin Soldier. Long ago, before plastic was ever invented, toy soldiers were often made from tin, and this story concerns one of them. The man who made the tin soldiers had received an order. "Make me 20," he'd been told by the father of a boy whose birthday was coming soon. "My boy loves tin soldiers, and so I want you to make him 20, all alike, dressed in red coats and black trousers like the grenadiers." So the tin soldier maker had set out to make 20 all alike. However, when he had made 20, he had a bit of tin left over, and so he set out to make another. The last one was just like all the rest except that he didn't have a hat. All the other soldiers had tall black hats, but the tin soldier maker didn't have enough tin left, so he left the last soldier without a hat. He still looked very grand, and the man who came to collect them said he didn't mind that one soldier was a little bit different than the rest. On the day of the birthday, the father arranged all the tin soldiers in a line as if they were on parade. Of course, there was an extra one, the one without a hat, and when the little boy saw him, he asked his father where the hat was. "I don't know," his father said. "We'll have to pretend that this soldier has lost his hat." The little boy didn't mind too much, but the trouble was that when he lined his soldiers up into ranks, there was always the one extra one, the one without a hat. And there was worse to come. When the little boy found a box to put his soldiers in, he was able to put just 20 in the box. The extra one didn't fit in. So that particular tin soldier found himself standing alone all on the window ledge in the playroom. There he stood, all alone, with his rifle on his shoulder, when all the others had gone to sleep in their box. After a while, when everything was quiet in the playroom, the little tin soldier saw that the moon was shining through the window. In the light of the moon, he saw, across the room, a little ballet dancer. She was made of tin, just as the soldier was, and she stood on one leg, her white skirt raised and her arms out sideways to hold her balance. The tin soldier thought she was beautiful. There was something about her that reminded the soldier of a swan, and that was not surprising because the ballet dancer was dancing Swan Lake. She was supposed to be a beautiful swan on a lake. The little tin soldier fell in love. But just then a terrible thing happened. The window was slightly open, and a gust of wind suddenly blew the tin soldier over. He first fell down, then he rolled a bit on the window ledge, and finally he fell out of the window into the street below. All night long it rained as the little tin soldier lay on the ground. He didn't like it much, but he kept saying to himself, "I must be brave, I must be brave." In the morning, the rain stopped and the sun came out. Two little boys were passing when they chanced to see the little tin soldier on the ground. They were delighted. They picked him up and were going to take him home until one of them saw how the rain was rushing water down the gutter. "Let's make a boat," he cried. "We can put the soldier in a boat." In minutes, they had made a tiny boat out of an old matchbox, and the tin soldier fitted inside. Then the two boys put the little boat in the gutter. They shouted with delight as the little tin soldier was carried along in the boat. The little tin soldier didn't mind. It was fun to be speeding along in a boat. But then, to his horror, he saw that the rushing water was leading directly to a drain. The two little boys could do nothing but watch as their boat gurgled down the drain. They tried to peer down to see where the boat had gone. But it was dark inside the drain. The little tin soldier held on grimly to the sides of his matchbox boat. The water rushed on, throwing the tin soldier from side to side until the drain emptied into a larger one that was so wide the tin soldier could not see anything but water. Still, he was glad the matchbox boat did not sink. But then the boat reached a point where the drain ran into a river. Once again, there was sunlight. The little tin soldier peered up from the bottom of the matchbox boat and looked around to see where he was. All he could see was a very wide river, and he was on it, heading for the open sea. After a while, there came another problem. The matchbox boat was leaking badly, making the little tin soldier wonder how long it would stay afloat. If he had had a hat, he would have used it to bail out water from his leaking boat, but he hadn't a hat. And using his hands to splash water over the side just wasn't good enough. Gradually, the boat began to sink. Once again, the little tin soldier had to say to himself, "I must be brave, I must be brave." Then the matchbox boat sank. It happened in a moment. One second, the tin soldier was furiously trying to throw water from his boat. Next second, he was in the water and sinking. For a tin soldier does not float. Down and down he went, swaying this way and that, and then, with a rush and a snap, a big fish had swallowed him down. It was very dark inside the fish. The little tin soldier lay in the belly of the fish wondering what to do, but he wasn't too uncomfortable, and after a while he fell asleep. In his dream, he saw the lovely ballet dancer again, smiling as she floated by. When the tin soldier awoke, he knew something new had happened. For one thing, he felt he was on dry land again. There was no movement at all, and everything was very quiet. What he didn't know was that the fish had been caught and was lying still on a table waiting for the cook to come. The first thing the little tin soldier knew was that a very large and very sharp knife was slicing through the fish, almost cutting him in half. He wriggled about to let the sharp blade pass over his shoulders. Then he heard a voice. "Look what's here! The fish has a little tin soldier inside him!" The cook picked up the tin soldier and cleaned him under a tap. "He seems to have lost his hat," he said. "But he's none the worse for that. I'll take him home for my boy." Then the tin soldier found himself again in complete blackness as the cook popped him in his pocket. But he was quite happy to be there, for it was soft and comfortable, and he needed a rest after all his adventures. After a while, he heard someone talking to the cook, and he seemed to know the voice. "There are a few things here my little boy doesn't want any more," the man was saying. "Perhaps you would like to take them for your son." "Oh, thank you, sir," replied the cook. "As a matter of fact, it's my son's birthday tomorrow, so he'll be very happy to see some presents." Then the little tin soldier fell asleep again. When he awoke, he saw that he was in a bedroom and on a table. Over in a corner of the room, he saw a young boy and girl fast asleep in their bed. Then the bedroom door opened, and in came the cook and his wife. They crept up to the bed and then began to sing gently, "Happy birthday to you." The little boy opened his eyes, and then wider still when he saw the presents on the table, his eyes fell on the little tin soldier. "Oh, wonderful," he cried, "just what I've always wanted." Then the little girl cried out happily, "Oh, look, look, a little dancer." "Yes, my love," said the cook, "and that's for you." The tin soldier looked round. To his amazement, he saw the little ballet dancer on the table beside him. The tin soldier was overjoyed, as were the little boy and the little girl with toys to play with. From then on, the little tin soldier and the ballet dancer were always kept together in the same box, and never again were they to part.